Though not a household name, Dick Dale was instrumental in guiding American culture, both figuratively and literally. He is most well known as the King of Surf Music, and sometimes as one of the godfathers of heavy metal. Dale was born in Boston, Massachusetts on May 4, 1937. His family soon after moved to nearby Quincy, where he would spend his formative years. It was here a young Richard Anthony Mansour, years before he would take his stage name, was first introduced to music by learning to play the piano from his aunt, and would go on to learn the trumpet and ukulele, the latter to emulate Hank Williams Sr., who he had grown to admire. This led Dale down the path of a musician, picking up his first guitar in his teens and teaching himself to play it. Dale was left-handed, but did not restrain his guitar like many lefties do. Instead, he effectively played upside down and would tap on the fretboard rather than wrapping his wrist underneath. He also played loudly and used heavy gauge guitar strings while deriving much of his budding sound from traditional musics from his Lebanese heritage. In 1954, his family moved to El Segundo, California. This is where Dick began his career in earnest. In his late teens, he did two things that would define his path in music. First, Dale's love of Hank Williams led him to the country music scene of Southern California, where he played small shows and was noticed by country western radio personality Guy Texas Tiny Cherry, who gave Dale his famous stage name. Second, he learned to surf. This cemented his signature sound, a mix of traditional Arabic scales, interpretations of animal screams and other natural phenomena, as well as extreme volume, to being termed surf rock. And Dale became known as the King of Surf Rock. Around this time, Dale wrote Leo Fender, creator of the now famous Fender brand of guitar equipment, asking him for a more robust amplifier, as he routinely burned out contemporary models during his shows. Intrigued, Leo traveled to Newport Beach, California to the Rendezvous Ballroom and witnessed Dale having to crank up the amplifiers to an unsustainable level to drown out the crowd admiration. The two made a perfect team as Fender would then build an amplifier and have Dale test it to see if it would blow up, stating, "When it can withstand the barrage of punishment from Dick Dale, then it is fit for human consumption." This pairing is perhaps the single most important moment in the first half of Dale's career, as he not only grew and perfected his surf style, he also gained a record deal. While he began self-published on his own label, Deltone, he would eventually be picked up by Capitol Records. Around this time, he also appeared on The Ed Sullivan Show to play his most well-known work, Miserlou, which was adapted from a Greek folk song. During this period in the early 60s was when Dale was most mainstream. His surf music sound became pop culture and it spawned a movement that would be incorporated into teen films of the time, many in which Dale himself would also appear. Most critics regard the mid-60s British invasion to be what would bring the spotlight down on Dick Dale. His career waned for the next 25 years as he fought rectal cancer and other health problems. Returning in the early 80s, he was nominated for a Grammy in 1986 and was able to connect with a new generation of guitarists he had influenced, such as cutting Pipeline with Stevie Ray Vaughan. In 1994, Quentin Tarantino would use Miserlou in the soundtrack of Pulp Fiction, and it and the movie are nearly synonymous. Tarantino's usage of the track would bring a much-needed career renaissance for Dale late in his life, and from here he would continue touring worldwide until his death. He considered this as much a blessing as a curse, as performing was physically excruciating, but he also needed to pay for his expensive medical care. On March 16, 2019, Richard Anthony Dick Dale Mansour died of heart failure. His life was one of a musical pioneer that influenced other legendary musicians from Jimi Hendrix and Stevie Ray Vaughan to Eddie Van Halen and the Ramones. He not only contributed to musical composition, but was also instrumental in the amplifier industry as being one of the first musicians to ever push the equipment beyond their theoretical and practical limitations. He routinely appears on top 100 guitarist lists and had a profound impact on American pop culture. Rest in peace, Dick Dale.